terrible for
Puck. Oh, Glimpse, top lane, Metamorphosis, Body Blocks from No-Tail. He didn't have mana. He actually had Thunderstrike instead of Kinetic Field, but they don't even need it. Kuroki comes in, and the Body Blocks from your Disruptor.
The Starks here coming back into the top lane against the Disruptor and Ancient Apparition. They just do so much damage if they can Glimpse you.
Impale, Wraith Fire Blast, bottom lane. Tether's going to go in a second, and it will. It'll slow him down. No Scorched Earth. Sibba will fall here. It looks like no. Stick Charge Mana Burn is not enough. Paris wants the kill. He's going to get it. It's actually going to jump in. S4 has Dreamquil. He might use it here. Mad's gonna come in. There's the Dreamquil onto two. He's good at the Cold Treat as well. Kinetic Field going in. They're gonna get caught out. Illusory Orb. Are they gonna get a double kill here? No, they pick up Kuroki. The Viper Strike coming in from the backside came through, I believe.
We are gonna see a Midas build coming out from the Wraith King. I really like the Midas when you're playing this support position Wraith King. It does look like they are gonna go on Funzi.
Oh, he's dead, man.
It's just so good against Starks here, especially in this early game.
It's going to be XP, and they really want this tower. It is in deny range. There's going to be the Cold Feet. No-Tail is taking in some damage here, but they will get the tower surge with a glimpse back coming in. Again. They don't have the kinetic field. Now Fudge is going to try to run at No-Tail. It's not going to work out. Mad wants the kill as well. He's like, please, please give me No-Tail. He has the impale. He's going to pop it. He will get the kill, but in the end, he gives away a death.
They're going to get
as well. Relocate coming in. While Ripka's down, there's going to be the usage of the Disruptor ult. No-Tail caught out. Wraith Fire Blast, he's done as well. It's one for one. There's the Dreamquil. S4 has no Illusory Orb for a couple of seconds. The Thunderstrike going in. Relocate. Illusory Orb. Winning Rift is there. He's going to use a triple kill for S4. The Puck player is back. There was Vendetta, but it's over now. They're mad. Ice Blast going in. Static Storm Geralt is just going to die. In fact, he's not even going for mech. There's the Wraith Fire Blast. They relocated in. Impale onto one. There's the Doom onto Mad, though. And it looks like he should fall here. Maybe not. They're going to come in. Reinforcements are going to go. They glimpse back Paris, I believe. Sibba's going to get caught out. Big wall coming in. Doom still onto Mad. And Paris is just running in. He still has his reincarnation. He's going deep. And he's going to get it popped. S4 does get the kill onto Mad in the meantime. Now Kroki going into work onto Paris with his usage of the Metamorphosis. He's getting chased down. They don't have No-Tail to glimpse him back.
The same reasoning why you don't get...
Oh, they met him in lane. Impale's gonna go. Big Dreamquil coming in. Illusory Orb, Waiting Rift, Static Storm on top of it all. They're getting low. Boom. Both will go down. The Ice Blast coming in. It helps out. And Doom does get one of them. Now here comes Mad trying to get away. He does the double damage room, but Spike Carapace already on cooldown. Try to get the Impale off. S4 is taking over this.
You have to Impale pretty soon.
Vendetta's gonna go. No, it's over. The Impale's gonna fly. He Mantas away from it. He had just got that Mantis style. The Viper Strike does come out. They're chasing Kuro down. He might have died. He's gonna TP away. He will make it out. Droom Coil onto two. Paris is gonna get Doom. No, rather, it's gonna be Mad. And he'll get chased down. Right clicked. He's dead. And they will relocate back out. They lose the Dark. So Geralt, he's going too deep. Static Storm coming in. Puppy will make it away as well. Geralt's gonna work on getting No-Tail. He might get this kill, but in the end, he probably will die. Glimpse is available for No-Tail if he wants to use it. He might. Illusory Orb, he's trying to jaunt. Juke jives. There's the Waiting Rift coming in as well. The right click will get the kill, but it's a monster kill for S4.
Ice Path even, because you can Ice Path and then Vacuum on top of it. So I think it's going to be very difficult for them to come back into this game.
They will find No-Tail from Matt, but he's not going to get the kill. They're just going to Cold Feed him, and he's dead. He's just dead. Somebody gets the kill with level death, and it's pretty nice, but...
This hero is all about getting up to level 16.
Well, he's going to die, it looks like. Silence is going to come through, and he's going to get relocated out. The Dreamquil came in, and it actually got canceled. Creo could not relocate out. Paris is going to get caught. There's the reincarnation coming in on the backside, but looking for Creo, he's going to fall. Viper Strike, did that miss? It did. S4 avoids it with his phase shift. Paris is going to get doomed up. A lot of rotations coming in from the side, and then at some point, you're just going to take this game. There's no real way to stop him. And they're going to go into Creo. The Waiting Rift of the Dagon comes in, plus one right click, and S4 just says, thank you very much for the gold. He is 11-0-5. He is beyond godlike. He has yet to die in this game. They're going to chase after Kuroki. There will be the Impale coming in from Mad. Yeah, he already uses Vendetta. Mana Burn. There's going to be the Rupture, rather the Sunder, excuse me. This is not a Bloodseeker. This is a Terror Blade. Thunderstrike going in. Mad is dead. He's going to go down. Glimpse back into Funzi as well. It's just that type of game, my friend.
He has to be in more precarious positions than that Wisp because, you know, he's a melee hero first of all, and he has to get in to cast his stun, and he's been trying to, you know, set up some pickoffs onto the Terror Blade, none of which have worked.
And he's probably going to die again here. Cold Feet going in. Meanwhile, S4 kills a hero on the back end. That was Funzi going down. And they will pick up another kill. Kuroki getting the one onto the... Mad's going to come in. They should have a gem for S4. He's actually not there currently. There's the Scotty, by the way. You said 23 minutes. You were right on the money. Matt is probably dead. Big Daddy is getting brought down by Paris, and he actually will fall, but here comes the Scotty of Kuroki, and Paris is slowed up. He's getting chased down. The relocate coming in as well. Paris probably should survive this. Ice Blast is going to whiff.
Kuroki can actually fight all these heroes, too.
Yeah, I mean, he certainly can go toe-to-toe, but they're going to wait and push in the creep wave and then go for it. Metamorphosis is still up for about, what's the duration at level 4? 52 seconds, I'd say about 30 seconds or something.
It takes S4 0.6 seconds to kill Io. Yep.
Well.
And if he continues leveling the Stagon, he can nearly one-shot him.
Funzy, what are you doing? Drawl's going to get brought down low with the Sag Scepter Doom, but they're not going to get the kill. Instead, they're going to go on to Paris. That's Reincarnation. Wow. BKB was picked up for Drawl. Kuroki is just melting Paris. He's actually just dead. Ice Blast, boom! Puppy snipes him from long range from downtown, and that's going to be the GG call coming in 24 minutes in. And Secret just run over denial. There's no other way to put it than that. What a game coming out from your dire side, Secret obliterating denial.
Yeah, I don't know, I don't like this support duo that they had, the Wisp and Nyx, because you want the Wisp to be a hero that sits on a lane, and then you need the other hero to be able to control.